Hey, I know a lot of your folks have been having this problem as well as I've been. So now that I have a solution which pretty much works for me, I just want to share it to the world. So the problem is YouTube doesn't completely support 16 by 10 videos, automatically converting them into 16 by 9 resolution, which just ruins the quality, making it look pixelized and blurry, especially for high-speed motion videos probably recorded at 60 fps and higher. For all the shadow play users who encountered this problem, this is probably what you've been looking for. Technically, YouTube converts every video you upload into its very own format, running it at about 6 megabits per second after all the compressions are applied. Everything that has a resolution of not 1080p is just out of YouTube HD standards, and still it handles it, but prior to destroying the quality. To make the most of the little we have and to save the quality, it's vital to upload a video that has an 1080p output resolution. That is the only way it can save the quality. Problem is, it's impossible to convert, say, a square into a rectangle without letterboxing or having black bars at the sides of your screen. 16 by 10 resolution records videos that are way wider than the same recorded at 16 by 9. Straight upload of 16 by 9 video to YouTube converts it into some crazy 17-18 by 1080 resolution, which is the essence and the main reason of your low quality problem. Nevertheless, there is a solution for this, which can be achieved with the help of Sony's Vegas Pro. I'm telling you at once, your videos are gonna look slightly letterboxed and will have black bars at the top and on the bottom, but only when you watch them on 16 by 10 screens, which is perfectly normal. This is how it works and how you achieve highest quality possible with videos recorded in non-standard, probably any non-standard resolutions at all. This is a sample of how 16 by 10 resolution videos gonna look like and pretty much what we want to achieve. So first thing we need to customize is to set the right project properties in Sony Vegas. You can create a new template, rename it and save it. You just need to set the width, the height and frame rate. If your frame rate is higher than 30 fps, you just set the way it is, because now YouTube can handle high fps videos. Other settings remain the same. The next thing you need to do is to go to track motion, and probably you want to create a new preset, naming the way you want, and just adjust the position the way you can see it on the screen. Those settings I'm giving you are adjustable and they work for my layout in most of the videos, but you can try dragging the borders and scaling it if they don't exactly match yours. Make sure that the video is set on the very first frame while you set in the track motion. Having set and scaled the video, you can launch the preview and see the way it will look after rendering. It should have black bars at the top and on the bottom, and your video is gonna look slightly letterboxed, but and be slightly cut as well, but still it will look nice. The next thing I want to show you is how to adjust brightness and contrast so that the colors remain close to the way they were before uploading the video to YouTube. All I know is no matter how nice your videos looked on your PC after straight after rendering, they're gonna look at least 20% worse after uploading. We can try to make it up by setting the right brightness and contrast settings. You need to select your video track and click on Track Effects. The plugin we want to choose is Sony Brightness and Contrast. So edit, and you may want to create a new preset as well, and settings of brightness, contrast and contrast center are those you can see on your screen. They are adjustable as well, and if you feel like dragging some of them, you just can do whatever you want. The video will look way too bright with very vibrant color, but this is what we want, as long as after uploading they will look just alright. It should be mentioned that YouTube seems to have problems with red color, and those parts of your video or inscriptions in red font can look slightly blurry. After you have finished editing of your video, you can render it with the following settings to achieve highest quality possible for the upload. You need to select the main concept AVC AAC category and click on any template that you want to customize. So we click on customize template, give it a name and set the frame size of HD 1080. We set the high profile frame rate of 60 fps, pixel aspect ratio of 1, number of reference frames of 2, we set the constant bitrate of 12 millions, and in the encode mode options we select render using CUDA if available. In the audio settings we set sample rate and bitrate just the way you see it on the screen. All the other settings are to remain untouched. By using these template settings, it renders the video quite fast depending on your system configuration and number of effects and transitions you applied. The less additional effects, color correction tools and transitions you have, the faster render will be completed. Hope this was helpful and have some wonderful time.